The Bible tells us that man is born unto trouble. Oppositions, difficulties, and sufferings are the lot of life. They are the reality of life. And oppositions outside do something to us on the inside. They do rock us. They do shake us. And that's what I read in 1 Thessalonians 3 and verse 3, that no man should be moved by these afflictions. While it is natural to be moved, to be quavering, to be shaking in the light of afflictions, yet the Bible tells us that we should not be moved. How then can we be steady in sufferings? Well, in these verses here in 1 Thessalonians chapter 3, I see that there are two things that will help you. First of all, in order to be steady in sufferings, you need to be reminded that they are the lot of life. That's a very obvious answer. You can be steady in sufferings when you are expecting them, when you know that they are real and you will not be caught off guard or surprised. We are appointed unto sufferings. It's a must. That's what Jesus says in John chapter 16. So first of all, don't be surprised when trials come or sufferings come. It's not that God is asleep. It's not that God is losing his power. It's not that God has left his throne or sovereignty. This is what we today are called to. Number two, in order to be steady in sufferings, you need the ministry of the one another's. Paul says, this is why in verse 2, he sent Timotheus, the minister of God, to establish you and to comfort you concerning your faith. We need the one another's to come into our lives to strengthen and to comfort us. So today, my dear friends, if you are going through sufferings and you feel like you are shaken, like those buildings that are swaying in the light of an earthquake, my friends, would you today be reminded by Scripture that you are thereby called to sufferings? And number two, would you avail yourself to the ministry of one another? You can't go on solo. You can't go on as an isolationist in the kingdom of God. We need one another, especially if you're serious about living for Jesus. Get yourself into a small group. Get yourself into a community of believers that you can receive and give the one another's. Life is tough. Don't go through it alone. God bless.